So we take our AM program, and in this AM program, remember we manipulated the amplitude information. And replaced the amplitude information into a multiplier. So just to make sure. So we've got our S of T, that's our input stream. So in this case, it's just a stream of minus ones and plus ones. The minus one corresponds to a binary zero, and the plus one corresponds to a one. And then we multiply this with our carrier cosine 2 pi fct. So that's our Pac-Man. Not the CK, it's just the C, the Pac-Man. So the Pac-Man is coded in our zeros and ones, and then they're turned into our symbol stream here. And then these symbols are multiplied with our carrier 2 pi fct, which is then generated our phase modulated signal. So that's our carrier. And at the end, I will do a Fourier transform to show that the carrier is actually gone. And okay, so let's do that. So here we've got our AM program. So in this AM program, we went through our bit stream here. And okay, so let's save this. So let's save this AM program now under a different name. So let's call this here now PM. So now what do we need to modify? So we need to look at these lines here, so we no longer have an amplitude. And so if the bitstream is one, the symbol is one. And if the bitstream is zero, so that's the otherwise, this is a minus one. So we are just multiplying this here by symbol. So not much change. But the important thing is now that we have a one and a minus one, and through this here we are generating a phase jump. So every time this switches from a zero to one, okay, during demodulation we are taking care in a minute, but let's just see if our PM signal is generated properly. There's another one we need to turn the A into a P here. And so let's see if we can run this here PM. So that's looking good. So let's plot our PM signal. So there's our figure. So now we instantly see there are no longer amplitude changes here. The amplitude is always the same. Amplitude is always one. But we see in here there appear to be some discontinuities in here. So let's have a look if this is true. Yeah, and so we see here that suddenly we are getting these phase changes here in the signal. So if I zoom back out, so we see different phase changes here in the signal, and that's obviously what we intended to do.